Welcome to the Rope Access Channel. My name is Alex, and this week we will continue in our gear series with the backup device, namely the PETZL ASAP. Let's go! As with harnesses, there are countless different types and models of backup devices. Every one of those backup devices should do one thing, and it should do that very good, and it is stop your fall as fast as possible. We are filming this in the Netherlands, and one of the most common used backup devices around, and my personal favorite, the PETZL ASAP. So let me tell you why this is my favorite. But first, if you like this content, please like the video and subscribe. Watch the full video, help me grow the channel. If you want to see any kind of other video on a certain subject, please leave a comment and tell me what you'd like to see and I get right on it. The reason that this is one of my favorite backup devices is its idiot-proof design. As long as it's attached correctly to the harness and to the rope, you are safe. Other backup devices depend on a camming function of the device to squeeze the rope and stop your fall or arrest your fall. The PETZL ASAP does not. It has a wheel inside with little teeth on it. And when the acceleration on the wheel is more than 2 meters per second, the wheel stops. The disadvantage of having a device with teeth is that they might damage the rope. So in order to prevent that, there's a shock absorber attached to it. It's a backup device, so a backup device always gets attached to the harness on one of the points marked with an A. So this one has an A, the one on my back has an A. I open the carabiner, attach it to my harness. I open the cam, I put the rope in, close it. Slides up the rope, rolls down the rope, slides up the rope, rolls down. In case of a sudden fall or my main line would break or I would step off a beam or whatever, it blocks and you're safe. To undo that, I push the wheel onto the rope and make a wheel turn, and then you can hear a little click and then the brake is released again. Here we go. Click. I hope the mic picked that up and now it will roll down. A thing to be aware of is if I'm making a long drop and I have 100 meters of rope above me and the wind is blowing pretty hard, like say 4 to 5 Beaufort, then the wind might push against the rope and actually pull it out of the device. So like this, it might happen that I have a couple of meters of extra slack in the rope, which you don't see because the wind is pulling on it. So if my main line would break, I suddenly would have like a huge fall going down. One of the things that PETZL integrated into it is this little locking pin, which I can pull down, and now the device does not slide down the rope. Right, so now the wind can't get it, and I will always be safe. It's a good function, but you also have to be aware of it, that before you descend, or in a case of a rescue, that before you descend, you undo the little clip. I undo the little clip and I can slide down again. Before we continue with this video, I would like to thank Industrio Klimmen in the Netherlands for sponsoring this video. They provide me with the opportunity to film in this beautiful location and bring you educational content coming from the rope access world. This is just one backup device. There are multiple different models. PETZL already has 3, this being the most advanced one. If you would like me to do a video on other rope access backup devices, please leave a comment and tell me which one you like to see. I'll dive full into it and we go into the detail. I would like to thank you for watching this video. I will see you in the next one when we get into the descenders. Stay connected.